Hey guys, it's Carolyn. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be about my experience working in Mammoth Hot Springs. So pretty much how I ended up in Mammoth Hot Springs, if you guys haven't seen my other videos, I went to work at Yellowstone National Park and got assigned to work in Canyon Village. But because Canyon Village is at the highest elevation in the park, they shut it down earlier than everywhere else and you get like a post-season assignment. So my post-season assignment was initially supposed to be Old Faithful, but I was dating this guy who got his post-season assignment in Gardner, Montana, and I was like, I want to be close to him. So they put me in Mammoth Hot Springs. And there was only a handful of Canyon kids is what we were called. We were rowdy, we had a reputation, but the Canyon kids, most of them went to Old Faithful. And I really only want to say there was like five or six of us that went to Mammoth Hot Springs. In Mammoth Hot Springs, the dorm I lived in, I can't remember the name of, but I do know it was the old person dorm. Like in all the other dorms in Yellowstone, you had quiet hours, which I think was between like 10 p.m. and 6 the next morning or something of that sort. But it was quiet hours all the time in my dorm. And like, while it kind of stunk that it was like the old folks dorm, we got like bigger dorm rooms, nicer dorm rooms, newer dorm rooms. And mine was actually supposed to be a three-person dorm, like we had three beds, but me and my roommate both came from Canyon, so it was just us two. And then she ended up quitting a week into us being in Mammoth Hot Springs because they put her in like a job called Dish Pit, which if you guys don't know what Dish Pit is, you just wash dishes all day long for 40 hours a week. And so she said, nope, not doing that, and quit. So I had just me in the three-person room in Mammoth Hot Springs. So if I can find some like pictures or videos of it, I'm gonna like put them here because literally it was like the coolest dorm ever. Like it showed up every other dorm I ever had while I was in Yellowstone. When I moved to Mammoth Hot Springs, I went from working in the deli that was in Canyon Village, which is now not there, it's all a cafeteria, but I went from the deli to the Terrace Grill. So if you guys have been to Yellowstone, the Terrace Grill is basically like a burger place. And so that was like a super big change of pace for me. I worked like back of the kitchen. Like I never checked anybody out. I just handed people their food and like made hamburgers and fries and stuff. But like that was a stressful job. We would have parties, busloads of like 70 people come in and we'd have to like cook all their burgers really fast. And then the burger's only good for half an hour after you make it. And then if they don't show up on time, then you have to remake the burgers. And it was a really stressful job. And then somehow, miraculously, after working there for like 2 weeks, I became a shift lead. So then I was stressed all the time, had no idea how to do my job, and I was in charge of people. So that was really fun. It was so much harder than my old job, and it was a really big change of pace. Like I was exhausted when I got off of work. I only worked there from like the beginning of September until the beginning of October, like around October 14th. And I never, not once, ever ate a Terrace Grill hamburger because no, not doing that. I don't have a ton to say about Mammoth Hot Springs just because I only lived there for about a month. But what I will say is their employee pub is much bigger and nicer than Canyon Village's. It has cool lights and it has pizza, which ours didn't. We just had like quesadillas. And it had darts, which was really cool, like real darts instead of like a fake dart machine. But it wasn't as wild as Canyon Village was. Like you couldn't get away with as much too because there were, you know, a lot of the higher ups in the Xantera company and things like that lived close to Mammoth Hot Springs. And there was also a forest ranger station and things like that not too far away. And those are the people that can get you in trouble. So people in Mammoth tend to be a bit more tame, at least, you know, on the surface, just because you could do things obviously without getting caught. But not a lot of people were really willing to try that. There were also a lot of older people in Mammoth Hot Springs. I don't know if it's because of its location being close to like Gardner, Montana or anything like that, but we had two or three people over the age of 50, I think, that worked in Canyon Village. And I swear there were so many people that were over the age of 50 working in Mammoth Hot Springs. Their dorms were also a lot more like sporadically spread out. In Canyon, it was very like cut and dry, like dorm, 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 dorm. But in Mammoth Hot Springs, it was like, there's one over here and over here and over here and over there. And there's two here and you gotta walk up this hill to get to this one. There weren't that many in Mammoth Hot Springs, but it just felt like it wasn't nearly as like organized, but it is a lot more like aesthetically pleasing when you're driving up to it. I wouldn't say there's like a better sense of community in Mammoth Hot Springs than there was in Canyon Village. Obviously I didn't get the full effect since I was only there for a month, But I think in Kenya, a lot of people were more accepting. Like, I could go sit with anybody I wanted to at lunch besides the Wranglers. And it would be okay. And, like, I could make new friends and, like, introduce people. And you met someone at the pub. And, like, y'all are 2 seconds later hanging out in y'all's dorms, like, just having a good time. And then in Mammoth, it was a lot less easy to make friends. Somehow I ended up with, though, like, the closest friends I have from Yellowstone, besides, like, my old roommate. But I talked to the people I met in Mammoth more now that it's 2 years later than I do the people in Canyon. So I don't know if it's because my last impression of Yellowstone was with them, but I really, like, I loved the people in Mammoth Hot Springs. They were just so kind and nice and, like, really funny. Like, me and three of my closest guy friends up there, like, drove to Bozeman, Montana at 2 a.m. to get Domino's. So even though I would say Mammoth Hot Springs isn't nearly as fun as Canyon Village, I think it definitely still has a lot to offer. If you guys are interested in working for Yellowstone National Park or working for Xanterra in Yellowstone National Park, I definitely highly recommend going and check it out. I just make these YouTube videos to share my point of view on these things, just because when I started to work there or when I got assigned my location, I had no idea about any of the stuff. So, like, I make these videos to try to help people so they're not like, what am I getting myself into? Very nervous about it, because I was really nervous about it. And I was just driving across the country into, like, a vast abyss of nothing. Like, I had no idea what I was doing. And it's really one of the coolest things I've ever done to this day. So thank you guys so much for watching. That is my little piece of working in Mammoth Hot Springs, even though I didn't do it for a full season. Did it for a partial season, post-season assignment, but I thought I would share my experience working there. If you guys want to check out any of my other videos or keep up to date on the videos I am posting, make sure you subscribe to my channel. And if you'd like to, feel free to like this video. Other than that, my Instagram name, gotta throw that in there, is @casuallycarolyn. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye!